Members of the victims return to the scene of the crime today to set up a makeshift memorial. Margaret Johnson continues our Big Story team coverage tonight in Mount Airy. Margo?
Well, Cameron, this area here in Mount Airy where the shooting happened is in a business district. Now, people who work here say it's usually quiet and peaceful, no drama like it is tonight. But all that was shattered when bullets started flying Sunday afternoon.
When they said four dead, I think, in a shootout, I thought, in Mount Airy? I mean, I just couldn't imagine.
He couldn't imagine it because the deadly shooting happened just outside the front door of Gary Chilton's insurance office. Sometimes he's here on Sunday catching up on paperwork, but not this time.
I wasn't real sure how I was going to feel when I got here this morning, and I'm still not real sure. I'm just glad I wasn't here.
Police say as many as 17 gunshots were fired in and around this parking lot. When it was all over, two people lay dead at the scene. Two others died at the hospital. Three of them were Jose Hernandez nephews, brothers Francisco Javier and Juan, plus their cousin Victor. They lived with him. Maria Zamora speaking for the family.
Picture yourself if it was one of your loved ones. It's so painful. It hurts.
Throughout the day, family members in tears, friends, and the curious came to the scene where it all happened. Part of the sidewalk is now a makeshift memorial of flowers and candles. Stacy Bowman is here to mourn. Three of the victims were her neighbors.
I just don't think people should go out like that. Something so senseless and didn't need to happen. And plus being so close to home, it shouldn't have happened. And I hate it for the families.
And all of these victims were very young. The youngest, just 21 years old, Marcos Aguilar. Now, family members say the word in their neighborhood is that their loved ones were killed over a woman in some kind of retaliation dispute. But tonight, they are Mount Airy's second, third, fourth, and fifth homicides of the year. And since we've been here this evening, this area has kind of turned into a vigil with more and more people showing up to say their goodbyes to the people who were killed. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Margaret.